Hello, my name is He Su Lee, an application specialist at Keysight Technologies. In this video, I would like to share an interesting yet very effective methodology that helps RF engineers perform practical RF impedance matching with SMT devices. The key concept of this approach is to find all possible combinations that meet the target impedance and loss specifications by post-processing all swept data from a list of SMT devices. The end result will show a list of good combinations given the available devices instead of tedious trial and error at the workbench. Let me show you how you do this with a Pi network matching topology. The Smith chart shows all possible input impedances generated by a combination of three components in the Pi network from a library of 12 SMT devices. The total number of possible combinations is 1,728, which is 12 times 12 times 12. The white area in the Smith chart represents the impedances we cannot achieve from the given combinations of 12 devices with a Pi network. We can do further data manipulation by assigning a target impedance and insertion loss specification. As shown in this ADS data display, you can enter the target impedance and total insertion loss specifications. Note that you are not limited to only two specifications. You could have more than two specifications, for example, maybe adding a target phase shift. The target impedance is specified by R plus J times X format with a radius. For example, if your target impedance is 5 ohm plus a little capacitance, you can enter the target impedance as something like 5 minus J times 5. In this example, let's set the target impedance to 46 minus J times 17 ohm and the insertion loss to be less than 1 dB. Now we can overlay the target impedance circle on all 1,728 impedance data points on the Smith chart. By moving the marker, you can read the impedance as well as combinations of SMT parts names that give the impedance. With some additional equations, we can add a filtering process to the data from the simulation to see what combinations meet the design specification. The data on this Smith chart shows only the impedances that satisfy the target impedance and loss requirements. Same for the loss plot below. The question becomes how many combinations of impedances meet the target impedance and loss specifications, and what are the names of these parts. By additional data manipulation, we can see a report of the total number of combinations satisfying the goal. Also, we can list just the set of combinations that will give us the desired performance. In this example, only 14 out of 1,728 possibilities meet the design goals, although all 14 cases provide a satisfactory result. It will be the designer's job to select the best combination from the 14 cases based on performance, cost, vendor preference, etc. You may question why we go with this method instead of optimization. The optimization technique should also provide a solution. However, it only gives you a single answer or one case that satisfies the design specification rather than a list of choices. Okay, let's take a look at the details. By the way, in this video, we may not go through every single detail of simulation setups or equations used, but remember that you will be able to download the workspace where you can find all the details after watching this video. Impedance matching for RF circuit is a very important task to ensure the best performance as well as cost-saving designs. This is especially true for wireless mobile product designs such as smartphones, to lengthen battery life from a single charge by improving efficiency. In the past, RF designers performed impedance matching using transmission lines such as microstrip and strip lines. However, many of today's mobile product designs have a fixed board layout, and so RF designers are limited to varying SMT values to achieve an impedance match. In most cases, the matching network topology is fixed to PI or T networks. It is a tedious and time-consuming process to manually try all possible component values, even with three components for PI or T networks. To understand the new methodology, let's start with a PI network matching topology. In the ADS workspace, you will be able to find schematic cell view called PI network impedance matching. Let's see how the schematic is constructed. There are three SMD components that are linked to the list of vendor data through DAC components. The simulation has a nested sweep for each SMT component and runs as parameter simulations in the end. For simplicity, the design frequency is set to a single value, 1.95 GHz, not a frequency band. The transmission line models represent the PCB layout. The load impedance, which is the port to termination in this case, can be any impedance, for example, measured antenna data. However, in this setup, we set the load impedance to 50 ohms. The SMT devices can be any device, such as capacitors or inductors, even an open impedance. With the open impedance, you simply remove the device from the circuit. The device models are typically vendor-supplied measured as parameters, such as a Murata as parameter library, but can also be any users supplied as parameters. In this example setup, four capacitors, five inductors, short and open impedance are used as shown in the text file. Okay, let's run the simulation. Since there are 12 devices in the list, it will eventually run 12 times 12 times 12 as parameter simulations, which is a total of 1,728 simulations, but it's fast, taking only 2 to 3 seconds. Nonetheless, the simulation time will get longer and longer as more SMT parts are used. As discussed earlier, you can analyze the simulation results at 1.95 GHz by setting up the design goals. Okay, now it would be interesting to see the frequency response of the network. Let's open the PI network frequency response schematic cell view. If we simulate all 1728 combinations from 0 to 10 GHz, it will be a pretty demanding simulation. We made a simple file name reduction utility function in ADS application extension language AEL, which generates a list of only the good combinations. Therefore, we only simulate the frequency responses of good combinations. Please refer to the README file in the ADS workspace for details. You can see the frequency response of all good combinations from 0 to 10 GHz. If you are interested in specifying other goals at different frequency points, you can do that too. In this example, we used three frequency points for the goals at 1.8, 1.95 and 2.1 GHz. This will reduce the number of good combinations since the design needs to meet additional design goals. What if we want to include rear PCB layout information? This can be easily implemented, and let me show you how this can be done. Here is a simple layout that includes a PI network matching topology, some interconnects and vias. We'll analyze the board with an EEM simulator to accurately characterize the PCB layout. Since it is a planar structure, we'll choose the momentum EEM simulator. Ports are assigned at the locations where we connect the remaining parts in the schematic. The EEM simulation only takes 2 to 3 minutes. The EEM simulated layout can be brought into the schematic as a layout look-like components, and the schematic is rearranged similarly to the first example we examined. The transmission line circuit motors are replaced by the more accurate PCB EM motors. Okay, let's run the simulation. We should notice some changes in the results compared to the previous example. One of the reasons is because the long transmission line in the PCB layout rotates the entire impedance seen on the Smith charts. An interesting thing is that there are now a total of 35 good combinations instead of just 14. By going through these steps, we can increase the accuracy of analysis as well as the completeness of designs. What about matching networks with a different topology, like a T network instead of pi network? Yes, it works the same way. In this workspace, you will find an example design with a T-network configuration. As you may notice, the results are similar but slightly different compared to the pi-network topology. You may find that one topology works better than the others by investigating and analyzing all possible good combinations. The number of good combinations is now 9 compared to 14 with the pi-network. Although we don't cover the T-network topology with rear PCB data in this video, you will find this example when you download the project. The process is very similar to the pi-network example. Is this methodology limited to only pi or T-networks? Not really. You can simply extend this idea to any topology. The only limitation is the longer simulation and post-processing time when more parts are involved. To demonstrate this, I created a 5-element ladder network example shown in this schematic. The setup was changed to 5 nested parameter sweeps. As you can imagine, it will take longer because all possible combinations now become 12e to the 5th, which is 248,832 simulations. We must consider the size of data we deal with as well, which will make the post-processing also slower. Although the simulation only takes 2 to 3 minutes, this leads to a practical limit of this methodology. Since the data size is large, I didn't include it in the project. You needed to rerun the simulation from your end to build the data and do the analysis. Let's take a look at the results. You can make almost any impedance with this configuration. The number of good combinations becomes 151 cases in this example. The cost of this would be using more space in the layout and more parts employed, although it may give you a better frequency response or higher harmonic attenuation, for example. Alright, now we have reviewed a very efficient methodology for RF impedance matching with SMT devices in this short video. I hope this helps your RF impedance matching for a better design. You can get the project file I use by clicking the link in the text description associated with this video or by typing in the URL shown on this slide. Thank you for watching this video.